Hey everybody, welcome to the first episode of the MDMC20 Facebook Live series. We're so excited to be back again this year. We did this series last year for the first time where we sat down and we talked to speakers about what is going on in the marketing industry, what to expect during their sessions, and what to expect at MDMC. So I'm really excited to have everyone back again this year to join me as we talk with some of the amazing Midwest Digital Marketing Conference speakers. So today, for my first speaker, we have the amazing Marisa Lather. She's known as @Marketer Marisa online, so you may have seen her around on Twitter and Facebook and LinkedIn. She is a data-driven design thinker who specializes in creating aesthetic brand experiences that delight. Which sounds very, very interesting. With an inbound marketing specialization in multimedia content creation and engagement, Marisa develops and executes omni-channel campaigns, blending online and offline worlds to create data-informed content and affinity-building experiences for brands. Wow, that is fantastic. So I would now like to introduce Marisa Lather.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for having me.
Yay, we're so excited to have you. Marisa's been a part of the conference for a long time, from attendee to helping us out with some influencer marketing to speaking at the conference, being a panelist or moderator. She's been involved with MDMC for a long time, and she's here in St. Louis with me as we are not snowed in anymore, but still heavily snow covered. But Marisa, could you expand a little bit on what you do in your job role and your specialties?
For sure. So I am actually the employment branding marketing manager at Proficient during the day, and then I transform into Marketer Marisa at night. And so it's really a lot of brand management. But as we move into this new decade, there is kind of a new landscape within marketing that we're facing, and that's what we're going to be talking about today, and then also at MDMC.
All right. Awesome. Well, I'm really excited to get in to talk about her session and some interesting topics. I think I forgot to introduce myself. It's the first one. I am Brianna Smith. I'm the executive director of the Midwest Digital Marketing Conference. So I help create this mad show that happens every April this year in 2020, but April 8th through 10th. But today, again, we're chatting with Marisa. If you're just joining us, make sure to throw your comments in or your questions below in the comments, and we will answer them throughout the show. If we don't get to your question, we will answer it in the comments later. But please shoot us your comments and your questions. If you want to just give us a quick shout out now, tell us where you're tuning in from. We would love for you to say hi. So I'm going to dive into some questions right now while you guys start filling out the comments. Marisa, can you tell us more about the privacy laws that have been implemented, including the fabulous GDPR? Fabulous is not the right word.
I think everybody will remember May 25th for a very, very long time. So I think even before we get into the different laws and regulations, it's important to think about how we as marketers are using data. For example, right now we're using it to qualify prospects, cross-sell, upsell existing customers, but then also create just a better experience. I think as we start to think about what kind of personalized experience we want to create, we have to start making decisions on what type of content we as marketers or as brands are collecting on those individuals. And whenever we're creating that personalized experience, there's nothing inherently wrong with that. I mean, even myself, I was planning a party and I couldn't figure out what party decorations to get. Well, thanks to a handy little display ad, I think we've all had this experience. I was actually served the perfect party game and I was able to buy it and I was converted into a happy customer. So it can actually be beneficial. But where we start to get into some of that murky gray area is when marketers are not using it in the way it was intended. So an example of that is when I fill out my email address so that I can download a guide or a white paper, but then I start getting advertised to, I didn't know about that. So it kind of breeds that distrust and disloyalty with that brand. So income regulations. And regulations on tech are nothing new. You know, back in 2003, California started rolling out different privacy laws. And in fact, right now there are over 13 federal level data privacy and security bills pending in Congress. And this is across states. Even across countries, places like Brazil and India are joining Canada and Europe in creating these infrastructures. And so what this does is it creates a bit of a no man's land, a wild west, with all of these different entities having their own governing rules and regulations. And so us in the United States, we're a little bit behind, but what we're finding is there's a lot of different people who want to institute different rules, and all of their motivations are not the same. So as we think about things like GDPR and like what's coming up, the California Consumer Privacy Act that goes into effect in January, you know, we as brands in America have to start thinking about how are we going to be able to comply with these upcoming regulations and what can we do to prepare. So it's going to be some of the things that we're going to be talking about.
Very interesting. And I think sometimes we forget as marketers, we know where data goes. We know, you know, we know, oh, I clicked on this, they're going to show me an ad, things like that. But the everyday person doesn't know those things. And they're like, why am I being shown that? It's so creepy. Like, to us, it seems like second
nature. Your phone is listening to you, right?
You click on it and you're, you know, analytics show. Well, you know, we got to kind of, I feel like sometimes take a step back and think about it from just the everyday person's perspective. I also just want to say, if you guys are joining us now, I know I have a couple, there's a few people that are just jumping in. If you have any questions, make sure to throw them in the chat. We in the comments. We are talking with Marisa Lather about data privacy and all the fun that goes along with that. she's one of our MDMC speakers. Marisa, can you tell me what considerations should marketers make to stay compliant and be a brand that consumers can trust, especially for those consumers that think you're just being creepy and things like that?
Well, there is a little bit of level of creepiness factor, let's be honest. But I think that's kind of a two-part question there. Whenever we think about compliance, you know, the first thing you need to do is make sure that you're consulting your legal advisors to make sure that you're compliant, because depending on your size, your revenue, what state you're in, what state your customers are in, there could be different laws that apply to different facets of your marketing and even just business and data strategies. So definitely get some legal advice as you go down this road. You need to see where you fit in. Something that everybody can do, though, is start to do a data inventory. Start to examine your data infrastructure. Who's receiving it? Who's governing it? How is it being stored? How is it being used? I think once you start to look at your data from that perspective, you can start to identify ways that you can better communicate this to your audience. A big way is within privacy policy, which could be part of your compliance depending on your company size, but you want to make sure that the user knows clearly how you're collecting their data, what you plan on doing with it, and make sure that you have your privacy policy that shows that you can make sure that you can erase the data. I think one of the things that is central around all of these laws, it's basically about how you identify, govern, distribute, and secure personal information. So it's really about the right to be forgotten. So one other thing you can do is make sure that you have processes in place and test them to make sure that you can delete user data should you need to. So that kind of takes care of a little bit of compliance. But then when we get into building trust, I think that this is probably the most fun in a way, because data compliance can be a little boring, however important it is, because you don't want to be fined. But it really goes back to being a brand that people know and trust. And so you're creating that culture of accountability and governance, and making sure that you're providing different ways that your audience can clearly see that whatever content you're serving them, whether it be a video or an article or white paper, that you have taken the steps to make sure that this is expert authoritative content. And so there are some front end things and some back end things. And that's another thing that I'll be really focusing in at MDMC about.
Awesome. So yeah, there's a lot that goes into it. And even I know one of my biggest pet peeves is about brands that aren't compliant is when I hit unsubscribe, please don't subscribe me. Like, so yeah. Small things, you know, it doesn't, if you're a small business and this seems overwhelming, there's just, even those things are your first steps to getting compliant and just being a good brand. Because I know everybody gets annoyed with that.
Well, and I think, you know, it kind of goes back to how we want to be perceived as a brand. You know, we don't want to be annoying. We want to find ways to authentically and organically integrate into our customers' life and truly add value. If you're not going to add value to their life, you're probably talking to the wrong person.
100% agree. I want to give a shout out and say hi, Shandy. Thanks for joining us and for commenting. If you are watching, guys, make sure to comment below with where you're watching from or ask any questions about how your brand can be compliant or if you're doing it right. But definitely ask Marisa some of your questions. So Marisa, how do you see the privacy laws evolving over time? I know you already mentioned they are coming to the States with the laws in California. And it's, you know, that's not going to change, you know, the spread of it. So I guess kind of both how it's going to change everyone in the US and then just kind of evolving over time.
Well, you know, like I said, we're already seeing privacy laws across a variety of different nations. So what we have to understand is who's going to make the decision about who governs our data. Is it going to be lawmakers or is it going to be these publicly traded companies who arguably have more data on us that we voluntarily give than certain organizations like the FBI and the CIA? So whenever you're thinking about how much data is out there, there's the ability to weaponize it. And we're even seeing people use social media as a weapon with misinformation, which I think really goes back to making sure that your audience can clearly see that whatever you're publishing is, you know, credible. So I think one other thing we have to take into consideration is we've got, you know, this is an election year coming up. And so while we have so many people who have an active interest in how our data is managed and stored, what we don't have is that alignment. And so with so many other pressing issues, the chances of tech regulation happening in 2020, experts aren't anticipating a lot of movement within the next year. But I think it's something that continues to be at the top of all of our minds. And so whether there's regulation or not, it's a good idea to be prepared. And I think a lot of the things that you do to prepare really just go back to being, you know, that credible, trustworthy brand. So, you know, by getting ahead of these things, you're not doing anything that you shouldn't be doing in theory already.
Awesome. Yeah. Definitely you should, you know, not just be doing it because it's, you know, required, but also doing it for your brand and living up to your brand. Shout out to Julie. Thanks for joining us. She is with Shandy in Edwardsville at Painting with a Twist. Hopefully you're not drowning in too much snow like we are. It slowly melts. Awesome. And thanks for everyone again for joining us. If you have any questions for Marisa about data privacy, make sure to throw them in the comments. One more quick question, and then I'm going to give you guys a little sneak peek at MDMC 2020. Andreas is watching from Panama. Awesome. Ooh, hi. A little warmer than here. Hi, Andreas. So, Marisa, and just some general, do you have any general like tips for marketers and marketing leaders, and maybe in regards to helping get people on board with some of these, you know, compliances and really getting them to see that it's critical and it's important, not just for a dealing with, you know, the law and everything, which is very important, but also from a brand perspective.
Definitely. I mean, I think we're certainly seeing some major fines, and each of these different regulations comes with their own fining schedule as well. But if that amount of money doesn't make you realize that the investment to prepare is worth it, take a look at them. I think as you start to think about how can I be, you know, a more compliant brand, it even goes back to things like influencer marketing and making sure that you have proper disclosures or disclosures on your post whenever you're working, not just with influencers, but even employees. And so instead of trying to scare everybody and you know, make you afraid of all of the different rules and regulations that are out there, I think one of the biggest things is awareness, especially as a leader. You know, you really have to have that bird's eye view on all of these different things. And you don't necessarily have to be the exact person to implement it, but you have to know what's coming so that you can adequately prepare your team. So I think first things first, make sure you're engaging legal counsel if needed. Certainly there are consultants out there that can support you through steps of this process. I've actually shared several articles and guides on my Facebook and LinkedIn and Twitter accounts. So you can look up Marketer Marisa that way and check some of those out. And I think really think about how you're going to overhaul your entire customer data infrastructure. So that could be as simple as making sure that you have a CRM in place, but you should start with a detailed data inventory, review all of your policies and procedures, and make sure that you're updating those data governance processes. Those are some easy ways that you can get started. And I think also it goes into thinking about privacy kind of by design. You know, how can you embed privacy into every technology and every engagement that you do? So this includes your relationships with your third-party vendors. You know, that's where a lot of cases have come through, by not having all of those different points secured. So that's, again, where using a consultant or a company can help support you as you go through this transition. And again, depending on your size is going to be what type of organization that you would engage for something like that. And then finally, you know, leaders really have to rethink what they think about marketing. You can't just push out a bunch of content anymore. It's not going to work because people are overloaded. They're overloaded and they're seeing so many fake things out there. They don't know what's real. Mm-hmm. So if you can start to create experiences, whether they be offline, online, or a convergence of the two, that's when you can really start to build that relationship that's hitting on that multi-sensory experience that you need to create those, you know, that engagement with your customer.
Yeah. Again, 100%. I think I said it before, but I can't agree more. We have a great comment from Shandy. I appreciate the privacy regulation. It puts conscientious marketers on the same competitive level as the less scrupulous, but still law-abiding marketers.
I agree with you. I think, and Brianna, I know we've discussed this before as well. Everybody was very afraid when GDPR came out and, you know, your email list is cut in half and, you know, who you can reach out to it's a completely different ballgame. But what we're finding is the people who stay are so much more dedicated, and they're those advocates that you really want to be talking to. So it goes back to really understanding your brand, spending the time and money in investing in the technology to learn how to learn your customer and learn what they like, but then also making sure that you're keeping that personally identifiable information a little bit separate and making sure that you're managing that properly as well.
Awesome. Great comment, Shandy. Okay, so now I'm going to give you guys a little sneak peek at MDMC20, and then we'll jump back to chatting with one of our great speakers, Marisa Lather, about her session that will be at this year's Midwest Digital Marketing Conference. All right. Let's see if I get this to work. All right. So there is a little sneak peek of previous year's MDMC events. This year, it is April 8th through 10th. We'll have over 80 workshops featuring, 80 sessions featuring over 90 speakers. We have 10 intensive workshops this year, including two new ones. One is Bulletproofing Your Brand, and one is a nonprofit marketing workshop that we're excited to add both of those this year. So make sure to head over to bestmarketingconference.com to check out all the sessions, including Marisa's session is the Playbook for Marketing in the New Age of Privacy, which I love the title of it. First of all, it is a great title. It will be on April 10th. So it's on the last day of the conference, but you guys are so many sessions you got to pick to go see. But first, Marisa, can you tell us kind of what people are going to learn at your session so they can decide if it's the right one for them?
Well, thank you for the compliment on the title. I thought being in such a sports-loving city that we could appreciate that reference. But on top of everything else, I really wanted this to be actionable. This is something that is for leaders, people who are forward-thinking, who want to get ahead of the pack. And this is designed to be an actual bit of information that they can take and digest from a high level, but then also some actionable pieces that they can take back and give directly to their team. I think as we think about how brands can establish trust and authority, we're going to be talking about different ways that can be executed, keeping privacy at top of mind through all of that. And then, you know, we talked a little bit about the awareness that business leaders will take from this session, but I think everybody can really get on board and frankly should get on board with understanding how their own data is being used. I don't know if anybody saw that Netflix special called The Great Hack, but it really dove into the world of Cambridge Analytica and the role that they played in several different elections. So it's kind of a good eye-opener for kind of the general public, how their data is being used. I think as marketers, we look at it and we're kind of like, oh, well, no kidding. We get that. But as we start to see customers have that more awareness about how their data is being used, how we're contacting them, with that greater awareness, that's when we need to start switching up how we're even reaching out to them in the first place.
Awesome. Well, if you guys feel like this might be something you're interested in, this might be the session for you. Marisa, as you both spoke and attended MDMC, so you know there's a lot of sessions to choose from. So finding the right one for you is always very important when building your schedule. So who do you think this session would be best for if they're trying to figure out how to build their schedule when attending MDMC?
Definitely. I think this is something that's going to be aimed for an executive audience, again, so that leaders can get that broad level of awareness of what's going on, but then be able to deliver different exercises and roll out recommendations to their team. So again, anybody who knows that they need to plan ahead, so especially if you're in an industry that is high on compliance, I would recommend coming. So financial services, medical. What you also might, I think anybody would really just enjoy this, frankly, because this is something that is so relevant to each of us. But again, is something that as marketers, we even need to be, you know, a couple steps ahead of everybody else. So.
We do. So definitely think about adding this to your MDMC schedule. Shout out to Bonnie Frank, who's been an amazing MDM speaker previously. And I know she does a lot with the University of Missouri St. Louis. So hey, Bonnie, she says privacy is such an important issue and one that most don't understand. Yes. Very, very true, Bonnie.
It's a lot to understand.
It could be really overwhelming. Yeah, and she also says that legal folks need to hear what you have to say too, which is very true. You need to work together.
That's true.
It can be very overwhelming, but by attending Marisa's session, hopefully you'll be a little less confused and overwhelmed, and you can, you know, see the way through the data craziness. So Marisa, you will be attending as well as speaking, and you're also moderating the data privacy panel, I believe. So she'll be busy, but when you aren't on the panel and you aren't in your session, who are you excited to see speak at this year's conference?
Well, I mean, I was looking through the agenda and there are so many different topics. So I love seeing the growth of topics that we're covering, the new speakers we have coming in, and then also some of the people. I mean, I have learned some of the top strategies at this conference. So I'm excited to hear what those people are going to deliver this time because, mm-hmm. you know, within marketing, it's like everything, you know, changes. I'd like to say from year to year, but let's be honest.
No, like week to week to week.
Yeah. So one thing that definitely talking about data-driven business solutions, Tara Kenny with Atomic Revenue. Mm-hmm. I am also really looking forward to, I believe it's some professors from St. John's University talking mm-hmm. about influencer marketing. And I know that they're going to be touching on compliance as well. And then, you know, when we think about building out those different experiences, Maria Ross is going to be talking about building empathy. And so I think those things go really, really well together with trying to create those aesthetic experiences. So,
I won't lie. It's gonna be hard to choose. It was hard to choose the speakers. Every year we get such phenomenal entries. We tend to get 3, 4, 5 times the amount that we can actually fit into 2 days. So it's hard to, you know, pick those, but I hope you guys really enjoy our lineup this year.
I will.
Me too. I don't see any more questions, but if you guys have any questions that come to mind, I know this can be kind of a confusing topic, but Marisa really helped us to understand how to use data properly and to tie it into our brand strategy, not just, oh, we have to be compliant. She talked great about that today. So if you guys come up with any questions afterwards, throw them in the comments. Or if you're watching this after we're live, throw them in the comments. Either the MDMC team or Marisa will jump in and answer those for you. And I hope that you can join us at the 2020 Midwest Digital Marketing Conference. It is April 8th through 10th in St. Louis, which we're both Marisa and I are right now. Tickets are on sale right now. They are as low as $179 until the end of the year, and then prices go up. So
it's unheard of for a conference like this, guys.
We are a nonprofit. All of our proceeds go back to the students at the University of Missouri-St. Louis in the form of scholarships and equipment, such as podcasting equipment and video equipment. And this is actually being produced by students right now. So they're learning how to do this live streaming tool. So you'll not just be learning a bunch, you'll be supporting some future marketers as they learn these awesome skills. So check out bestmarketingconference.com, and Marisa and I hope to see you in April here in St. Louis.
Maybe even before that. Who knows?
I hope so.
Well, thank you so much for having me, Brianna.
Thanks.